As of August 4th, 2022, I am no longer a member of the Extreme Racing League or XRL. It was a very difficult decision to make, but a lot of it came down to the way my health has been over the last few months. My health took a huge hit over the course of this year after I contracted COVID. And since then, I have had difficulty with my breathing. And according to my doctor, I had a degree of asthma, which not only affected my breathing, but it sometimes, more often than not, affected my sleep at the same time. And that in turn affected my race performances. I had occasions where I turned up to race, even though I was less than 100%, because of how dedicated I was to the sport and especially the league. But as a consequence of that, it affected my performances both on and off the track. And that's why I've made the decision that I've made, to focus on myself, as well as focusing on making sure that I can perform to the best of my ability. Again, not an easy decision for me to make, but I was part of the league from the start, from its inception. And although the X1 division finished early, I was still able to call a majority of the X1 races, with the occasional appearance in the X2 division as a commentator. I also had the opportunity to race in three of the four divisions, with the Development League, X3 and X2. My most recent appearance was this past Sunday, October 2nd, where I was unfortunate enough to crash at Baku and as a result, I was given a race ban for the next race in Canada. And while I don't agree with the steward's decision regarding giving me a race ban, it's difficult to argue a steward's decision without providing evidence to appeal. And those are the risks you have to take. If you don't have the evidence, then not much you can do about it. While I don't agree with it, while I don't agree with the decision, those are the consequences I have to live with. So everybody that's been involved in the league from the start and those that have been there along the way, Caesar, Michael, Caesar, Michael, Insane Leader, everybody that's been involved, Ivan, Willem, everybody that's been involved on the commentary team, involved in the stewarding, everybody on the admin teams, everybody that I've seen race or I've raced against. Thank you for allowing me to be part of the community. Because it made Sunday nights very enjoyable for me. For the most part. Again, because of my health issues, but that's odd. I never wanted it to come to this. But at the end of the day, as I've mentioned, I have to put myself and my health first. And that means leaving the league and focusing on myself physically and especially mentally. I will always be grateful for the opportunities that I have had since I started doing commentary for the various leagues that I have been part of over the years. But with XRL, it was probably the closest thing it felt to being an actual sports broadcast to me. I will miss commentating on a Sunday with XRL, but now that I have the time to focus on myself as well as making sure that the other racing communities that I'm part of, that I can be as prepared as I can be to either race or to commentate with them. One of my favourite highlights of the season, one of my favourite highlights has to be commentating on championship deciders. Races that have decided championships that weren't the final race of the season. The opportunity that I had to promote CD keys every week with the recommendations that I had in terms of gaming. And the people I've met along the way. It's been an incredible 3 years that I've had with XRL. And now it's time for me to focus on myself and prepare for what the future holds in store. And all that's left to say, thank you very much, XRL. I'll have a bit of that.